My name is Radim. As you know, today I want to tell you about the Teigha cereal. This product is quite familiar to some of you already. So, what Teigha cereal provides? Teigha cereal provides the API for cereal engineering objects. The 7-3D product compatible. It has internally the support for object styles when the rendering of objects of the same style can be changed by editing the style, since the styles of objects are also double JTTs. We are able to import and load objects for civil engineering from Civil 3D version starting from 2006 and up to 2018. But I need to mention that after importing, all objects are converted to the most recent format of 2018 and saved in that form. So there is no ability to save all the objects versions. So for the most of the entities, rendering is implemented. So we have object creation support. Teigha cereal is the special interest group project. What that means? That means that it's funded by a group of our regular members for additional fee, and the development of this product is driven by those customers, and they define the priorities and the direction of development. For the evaluation purpose, you can check the trial version, so it's available on our website. So for the past year, we implemented support for 2019 format. The format for civil 3D objects actually changes almost each year. It's much more frequently than the DWG format itself. So we extended the API to provide the access to data of the serial objects. We improved the PyTorch's 3D representation, and we implemented, by request from our members, the rendering for pressure pipes. Okay, some details. For the past year, we added more than 400 public methods. It's particularly for pressure network data access, for profile view properties. It's for label styles, for all supported entities. And we added the API for 3D solid of pipes and structures. And for the 3D rendering example, or the instance, we migrated the rendering pipes and pressure pipes networks from simple faced bodies to valid 3D solids. And the API conforms to the Civil 3D.net API, so if you are familiar with that API, it will cause not so much work to use Teigha cereal in your product. For the next year, priorities it's the rendering for fitting the walls, 3D rendering for crude pipes of arbitrary sections, so we have such requests for the upcoming year. We will continue to extend the public API, and we continue to work on the object creation and editing to make someday the Teigha cereal as mature as, for instance, Teigha architecture or other Teigha products. To be able to integrate and build vertical application upon Teigha cereal. So some examples, just to have the idea what are the cereal engineering projects. You can see the surface parcels, alignments. Here you can see the support of different styles for the parcels, for example. So here you can see the corridor and corridor intersections with analysis profiles. Example of displaying properties and labels for parcels. So you can see the pipe network and pipe structures over the surface. So it's also in 3D mode. So the display presentation and render display style for the surface has changed. And the triangulation mode for the surface rendering. And the realistic mode for the triangulation rendering. So, and I want to show you a short demo, which gives an idea how this API can be used to work with the civil engineering data and to create actually the civil engineering DWG files. So we are loading sample. So the source code is available to our CIM members of that sample. So we open a template file. So some objects in there. And let's imagine that we have data from the field team or scanned for the geosurfaces. And we are trying and we will create the surface object for the geology file for compatible with CO3. So, name, remote. So this this comment adds some data. Let's just look into the file, and we can see that this is just a set of points with an ordered row. So they are just in random order. I would say that. So with the coordinates and the height. So these are not actually the real geodata, but some synthetic data. So open them, import them into the drawing, and we get the number of the geo points in sense of the CO3D idea. So these are CO3D objects compatible with all the CO3D stuff. Another case, we want to build the surface upon those points. So this is the triangulation mode, which, by the way, implemented recently by also the request, and we can see that. See that there are haze on this surface. So some other modes are also implemented. For instance, the reformer to see the contours. We changed the representation for this real surface, and you can see the width, the contours, and some other cases. For instance, when we have additional data arrived, so here we can see that since some data is missing here in this area, and when we get additional real-world data there, we just add those coordinates and heights there, and we are able to rebuild the surface and refine the data. So the same, not for refining existing areas, but if you have the additional additional points to the west of this area. We can go down. And the surface is extended. So we can see that this is the solid surface objects which will be used for analysis of heights, doing alignments upon it, and to build all the rest civil engineering projects as roads, pipe networks, and so on. So, that's it. Questions? Oh, thank you.